Father, in the name of Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, tonight, my brothers and sisters, rise in the legal authority and dominion that you have given us according to Ephesians 6 against all principalities. Lord, we ask that you would forgive us for our sins of omission and commission that open doors that would allow the enemy access into our lives. We come against this python spirit and its cohorts. In the name of Jesus, I break all soul ties with anyone that my brothers and sisters have picked up from these spirits. We stand separate and apart from them. In Jesus' name, according to Matthew 18:18, we take authority over you, Satan, this day, and bind and cast out the python spirit and your demons of witchcraft, divination, heaviness, weariness, fatigue, frustration, confusion, depression, and oppression. The seducing spirit, the beguiling spirits, the Jezebel spirit, and the spirits of control, domination, and manipulation that have plagued my brothers and sisters. I command them to go now in Jesus' name. Get out, you python spirit, and all your cohorts. Get out of here now. Come out in the name of Jesus. Every single one of you, get out. Come out now in the name of Jesus. Untwist your filthy snake serpent ways from my brother's sis and my sister's minds, body, soul, and spirit. I plead the blood of Jesus at the root at which these came in. I close these doors now in the name of Jesus. I seal them with the blood of the Lamb that was shed on Calvary's cross for the redemption of my brothers and sisters, for the judgment, and I forbid them in the name of Jesus to come back and harass my brothers and sisters in any way, shape, or form. And I forbid them from touching anyone else on their way out. Go immediately directly to Jesus Christ. Jesus is Lord and Babylon is fallen. You are defeated, Satan, so get out. I ask the Holy Spirit to come upon my brothers and sisters now to the maximum. Purify and cleanse their mind, body, soul, and spirit, their conscious and their subconscious, Lord. Please go into the memory bank of my brothers and sisters' brains and erase any damage there is, any confusion in the chambers of their minds, so that they will never again be bothered by these spirits and by the python spirit. Go into the memory bank of their hearts, Almighty God, and erase the emotional trauma that is there. Go into the memory bank of their guts where they experience the pain and the hurt from these spirits and from the people who have done emotional damage against them, and erase it with your Holy Spirit, God. There is nothing too difficult for you. Place your healing balm of Gilead in all of my brothers and sisters' memory points. Lord, forgive them. Forgive us if we have been using the python spirit to manipulate and control anyone else. We submit and surrender ourselves wholly and totally unto you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I loose now your healing power, Lord. Healing and freedom now against these spirits, from these spirits that have held my brothers and sisters captive in the name of Jesus. I ask that you would now send forth your warring angels on their behalf to warfare for them and defeat the enemy and his cohorts. I thank you that you have not left us alone. I thank you that we can come to you in prayer and we can know that you hear our prayers. I thank you, God, that my brothers and sisters will experience miracles, signs, and wonders in their lives as you heal them from the past through this moment. I thank you, Almighty God, that the plans and the purposes that you have over their lives will prevail. They cannot be stopped. You fashioned them, formed them in divinity. You said that you had plans for their lives. And so I declare that the plans and the purposes of God over their lives come to pass. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that you would empower them to believe that all things are possible through him who loves them. All things are possible for him who sacrificed his life on the cross, that they would be brought back to you. Thank you that there is no part of their lives that is untouched. Thank you that there is no part of their lives that is unhealed. You're a good, good God. And we stand in awe of you tonight, God. I thank you that you are doing wonders in their lives. I thank you, God, that even as they raise their children, their grandchildren, and as they interact with their family members and their friends and their co-workers, there will be evidence that Christ, the life of Christ, the mind of Christ is upon them. There will be evidence that you have done a work in and through them. I pray for their businesses. I pray for their homes. I pray for their finances. I pray for their relationships. I pray for their secret prayers that they're too afraid to admit. Lord, grant them the desires of their hearts. Birth forth your purpose in their lives, because we know that the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. And it is so. So we thank you. We acknowledge that without you, we are nothing. And we throw ourselves at your feet, totally dependent on you, God. Do what you will do. And we give you all the glory. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.